Hello guys, I am Arvind and in this lecture I am going to discuss popular Python libraries. So without wasting your time, let's get started with the popular Python libraries. So this lecture is aimed at beginners who want to be expert in Python programming. To be a good programmer, it is not necessary to know all the libraries there are in any language. However, there are some libraries that every programmer should know well. So Python is one of the most popular and widely used programming languages and has replaced many programming languages in the industry. Every language has its own library, but because of the huge number of libraries, Python is becoming more popular among machine learning professionals too. So the first library in this topic is TensorFlow. So let's discuss TensorFlow. So if you are working on machine learning project in Python, then you might have heard about this famous open source library as TensorFlow. So this library is used to help you to develop and train machine learning models, and it was originally developed by Google in partnership with Brain Team. And TensorFlow is used in every single application of Google for machine learning. And here you can find out the link for TensorFlow. So now moving on to next topic, and that is Keras. So Keras is considered as one of the coolest machine learning libraries in Python, and it provides an easier mechanism to express neural networks. Keras also provides some of the best utilities for compiling models, processing data sets, visualization of graphs, and much more. And here is a link given for Keras. So now moving on to next topic, and that is NumPy. So NumPy is considered as one of the most popular machine learning library in Python. TensorFlow and other libraries uses NumPy internally for performing multiple operations on tensors. Array interface is the best and the most important feature of NumPy, and here is a link given for NumPy. So moving on to next topic, and that is scikit-learn. So it is a Python library that is associated with NumPy and SciPy, and it is considered as one of the best libraries for working with complex data. And you can find out all the information related to scikit-learn on this URL. So now moving on to next topic, and that is PyTorch. So PyTorch is the largest machine learning library that allow developers to perform tensor computations with an acceleration of GPU, creates dynamic computational graphs, and calculate gradients automatically. Other than this, PyTorch offers rich APIs for solving application issues related to neural networks. This machine learning library is based on Torch, which is an open source machine library implemented in C with a wrapper in Lua. So you can find out all the information related to PyTorch on the URL given below. So let's move on to the next topic, and that is Matplotlib. So Matplotlib is a plotting library used for 2D graphics in Python programming language. It can be used in Python scripts, shell, web application, servers, and other GUI toolkits. So it gives an object-oriented API for embedding plots into applications using general-purpose GUI toolkits like tkinter, WXPython, Qt, or GTK+. And here you can find out the link for Matplotlib. So now moving on to next topic, and that is Pandas. Pandas is a machine learning library in Python that provides data structure of high level and a wide variety of tools for analysis. Pandas have so many inbuilt methods for grouping, combining data, and filtering, as well as time series functionality. And here is a link given for Pandas. So now moving on to next topic, and that is DNO. So DNO is a computational framework machine learning library in Python for computing multidimensional arrays. DNO works similar to TensorFlow, but it is not as efficient as TensorFlow because of its inability to fit into production environments. So here is the link given for DNO. So now moving on to next topic, and that is SciPy. So SciPy is a machine learning library for application developers and engineers. SciPy library contains modules for optimization, linear algebra, integration, and statistics. The essential component of the SciPy library is that it is produced using NumPy. So below is the link for SciPy. So now moving on to next topic, and that is ELI5. So most often the results of machine learning model predictions are not accurate, and ELI5 machine learning library built in Python helps in overcoming this challenge. So it is a combination of visualization and debug all the machine learning models and track all working steps of an algorithm. And here is the link given below for ELI5. So let's go ahead and we discuss next topic, and that is LightGBM. So the LightGBM is a gradient boosting framework that uses tree-based learning algorithms, and it is designed to be distributed and efficient with the following advantages. Faster training speed and higher accuracy is the first advantage. Lower memory uses is the second. Better accuracy is the third. And support of parallel and GPU learning is the next. And capable of handling large scale data is the last. And if you need further information regarding LightGBM, then you can find out the link given below. So now moving on to next topic, and that is requests. So the requests is a Python library that lets you send HTTP requests, add headers, form data, multi-part files and parameters with simple Python dictionaries. It also lets you access the response data in the same way. And here is a link given for requests. So now moving on to next topic, and that is SQL Alchemy. So the SQL Alchemy is a library with well-known enterprise level patterns, and it was designed for efficient and high performing database access. And you can find out all the information related to SQL Alchemy in the link given below. So let's go ahead and we'll discuss next topic, and that is Beautiful SOAP. So this is a Python package for viewing HTML and XML documents, and it makes a parse tree for parsed pages that can be used to extract data from HTML, which is effective for web scraping. It may be a bit slow, but Beautiful SOAP has an excellent XML and HTML parsing libraries for beginners. If you need more information regarding Beautiful SOAP, so you can find out the link given below. So let's move ahead and we'll discuss next topic, and that is Piglet. So Piglet is an excellent choice for an object-oriented programming interface in developing games. In fact, it also finds use in developing other visually rich applications for Mac OS X, Windows, and Linux. And here is a link given for Piglet. So let's go ahead and we'll discuss next topic, and that is Scrappy. If your motive is fast, high level skin scraping and web crawling, go for Scrappy. And you can use it for many purposes, from data mining to monitoring and automated testing. And here is the link given for Scrappy. So let's go ahead and we'll discuss next topic, and that is Pygame. So the Pygame offers an extremely easy interface to the simple direct media library, platform independent graphic, audio and input libraries. And you can find out all the information related to Pygame in the link given below. So moving on to next topic, and that is Twisted. So Twisted is an event driven networking engine that is written in Python and licensed under the open source MIT license. And you can find out all the information related to Twisted in the link given below. So now moving on to next topic, and that is Pillow. So a friendly fork for PIL, that stands for Python Imaging Library, So Pillow is a free library for Python programming, which also adds support for opening, manipulating, and saving different image file formats, and it is available for Windows, Mac OS X, and Linux. Being user-friendly, it is must-have for everyone who works with images. You can find out all the information related to Pillow on the link given below. So let's go ahead and we'll discuss next topic, and that is PyWin32. So the PyWin32 provides useful methods and class for interaction with Windows, as the name suggests, and you can find out more information on the link given below. So now moving on to next topic, and that is WXPython. So WXPython is a wrapper around WX widgets for Python, and it is the cross-platform GUI API WX widgets for the Python programming languages, and it is one of the substitute for Tkinter, which is packed with Python. And you can find out all the information related to WXPython on this link that is given below. So now moving on to next topic, and that is IPython. IPython library has an architecture that facilitates parallel and distributed computing. With it, you can develop, execute, debug, and monitor parallel application. And here is the link given for IPython. So now moving on to next topic, and that is Nose. So the Nose library delivers an alternate test discovery and running process for system tests. So you can find out all the information related to Nose on the link given below. So now moving on to next topic, and that is Flask. So Flask is a web framework, and that is built with a small core and many extensions. The Flask is a lightweight WSGI application framework that enable users to get started quickly and easily with the ability to scale up to large and complex applications. And you can find out all the information related to Flask on the link given below. So now moving on to next topic, and that is SymPy. It is an open source library for symbolic math with every simple and comprehensible code that is easily extensible. SymPy is a full-fledged computer algebra system that is also known as CAS, and it is written in Python and hence does not need external libraries. And you can find out all the information related to SymPy in the link given below. So now moving on to next topic, and that is Fabric. So along with being a library, Fabric is a command line tool for streamlining the use of SSH for application deployment for systems administration tasks. With it, you can execute local or remote shell commands, upload or download files, and even prompt running user for input or abort executions. So here is a link given for Fabric. So now moving on to next topic, and that is PyGTK. PyGTK is a free program, and it is certified under LGPL. PyGTK lets you easily create programs with a GUI with Python. And here is the link given for PyGTK. So now moving on to next topic, and that is Django. Django is a high-level Python web framework that encourages rapid development and clean, pragmatic design, and it is free and open source. And you can find out all the information about Django on this link. So now moving on to next topic, and that is PyQt. PyQt is a GUI widgets toolkit, and it is a Python interface for Qt, one of the most powerful and popular cross-platform GUI library. PyQt is a blend of Python programming language and the Qt library. And you can find out all the information about PyQt on the link given below. So now moving on to next topic, and that is NLTK. The NLTK stands for Natural Language Toolkit. The Natural Language Toolkit or NLTK is a platform used for building Python programs that work with human language data for applying in statistical natural language processing, or we can say NLP. So here is a link given for NLTK. So now moving on to next topic, and that is tkinter. Tkinter is the standard GUI library for Python. Python, when combined with tkinter, provides a fast and easy way to create GUI applications. Tkinter provides a powerful object-oriented interface to the tkinter GUI toolkit. And you can find out the information regarding TK or tkinter on the link given below. So now moving on to next topic, and that is Jython. It is also known as JPython. So JPython is an implementation of the Python programming language that allows programmers to use Python as a scripting component in Java-based applications. So in short, JPython makes Python code look like Java and consequently offers a variety of technology options inherited from the Java world. With JPython, Python code may be run as client-side applets in web browsers, as server-side scripts, and in a variety of other roles. And you can find out all the information related to Jython on the link given below. So now moving on to next topic, and that is Seaborn. Seaborn is a Python data visualization library based on Matplotlib. So it provides a high-level interface for drawing attractive and informative statistical graphics. And here is a link for Seaborn. A basic knowledge of these Python libraries will help you kickstart the mastering of the libraries available in Python. And thank you so much guys for watching this video, and I hope you liked it. And if you liked it, do not forget to like and subscribe. I will see you then in the next video. Thank you so much, guys.